tend to find a conflict or problem in anyway. So also sustainability. So although the main theme of this conference is to look at the sustainability from a very wider perspective, more unique perspective, and I try to accommodate my presentation to this wider perspective, but still my background may affect my presentation. But anyway, so in spite of the very long title, I would like to make my presentation as short as possible, and I will focus on the certain aspect of the path I'm looking at. So if you are interested more about this topic, please read my full paper. So it will be available pretty soon, or maybe already available. So this is just a map of the East Asia, including Southeast Asia. Yeah? So later my focus would be China, actually. China, how China is changing its perspective on the sovereignty issue. This will be actually my focus. Anyway, so just China and the Southeast Asia and the South China Sea over there. And so this one is shows the very famous so-called 9 dotted line. So this one, yeah? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Previously it was 11 dotted line, maybe here. But now this part disappeared. Actually the Gulf of Tonkin, so the demarcation of the sea already settled here between China and Vietnam now. So anyway, so now China is this line, 9 dotted line, or a U-shaped line, as China's territorial sea. Actually, there's not so clear about China's position about this sea. So anyway, so later we have new focus, China's claim. According to China has the sovereign claim over this area. And then this one shows the overlapping of the plates of the littoral state. So complicated. This one more or less represents China's U-shaped line and the Philippines and Brunei here and Malaysia and Vietnam. So a lot of overlapping. So my focus would be how to handle this overlapping actually. So introduction, so dispute on the South China Sea and its management. So I'm focusing more management side. And there's a long lasting dispute and effort of management with ups and downs. Sometimes tensions going up, sometimes tensions under control or going down, whatever. But anyway, so this is a very long lasting dispute and effort of management, as you already know. But a certain order over its management can be identified. So this dispute is not so chaotic, actually. And maybe in the early period, there might be some scramble for each country to occupy as many small islands as possible. But somehow there seems to be kind of order how to manage this dispute. So I want to identify this order, and then I want to have a closer look how this order emerged and made it maintained. So my propositions. So fundamental incompatibilities. Usually incompatibility always involves in conflict or dispute. So incompatibility. Incompatibilities over territorial sovereignty may be addressed by accommodating to each party's ideal state. So I used German one to in respect of many people from Germany. So Dorn. So what it should be ideal state. What is the ideal state over the South China Sea? So this one different, depending on the Vietnam, Malaysia, Brunei, and China, whatever. And then the reality on the ground, actually in the South China Sea. So this is Genoa, in Genoa, Zain, and then Zoren and Zain. So these compatibilities may be addressed by accommodating the Zoren to Zain in the South China Sea. Okay, the second proposition, the concept of tributary system in Southeast Asia. This one is a very historical thing. So the tributary system created, maintained by China dynasties, ancient dynasties, especially the Ming dynasty, Ming dynasty. This concept may help or may give us some suggestions in accommodating the Zoren to Zain in South China Sea. So I want to provide two propositions of my presentation. So what follows in the presentation? So the first, I will provide a theoretical framework. In my field of research, peace and conflict studies, always the theoretical framework is considered important. I like to provide certain framework. Those people from UBD, you already know about this one because I'm always proposing this theoretical framework. So please just be patient for both of you. Yeah. So the theoretical framework is mediation regime and the hybrid system. I will explain a bit more later. And then after that, I will apply this theoretical framework to the South China Sea dispute management. Then conclusion. Okay, anyway. Then theoretical framework, mediation regime. So what is this mediation regime? So the first, I start with international regime. So this established concept. This one is a set of principles, norms, rules, and decision making procedures. Decision-making procedures around which after expectations converge, common understanding on these things. Yeah. In a given issue area, any area, for example, maybe global warming issue, and or maybe the environmental issue, and maybe narcotic control issue. So the international regime can be created over this certain issue area. This is international regime, this idea. So the important point is that each country knows how other country will behave on certain issue area. So mutual understanding and maybe expectation.